The government of the Cayman Islands is striving to achieve sustainable development by providing better protection for the island's natural resources.
The draft national conservation legislation does a number of things. Specifically, it sets up a National Conservation Council that would be responsible for proper administration of the law. The legislation also, for the first time, recognizes the Department of Environment and helps to define the Department of Environment's roles and functions. The legislation also allows us to prescribe protected species and protected areas, marine and terrestrial. It also sets up a comprehensive enforcement procedures mechanism. The legislation also contemplates the establishment of a conservation trust fund, which would be used basically to carry out actions under the law, including, for example, buying land in order to set aside that land as a protected area.
Modernizing the law is critical to preserving the way of life of the Cayman Islands while tackling global threats.
Our economy is largely based on utilization of our environmental resources through tourism, but also the environment is important because our survival here in the Cayman Islands depends on a healthy and properly functioning environment. We're very vulnerable to storms, so we depend on our mangroves and our beaches and our coral reefs to help mitigate the impacts of those storms. The third main issue I would say for the environment is really loss of our biological diversity, which is another way of saying the variety of life that we have here on the island is important. It's important because the diversity of life impacts the way that our environmental systems function, and it also impacts our quality of life.
Endangered plants and animals will also have better protection.
Species under threat in Cayman unfortunately tend to be the species that are special, that are peculiar to these islands. For example, we have our blue iguana. The Cayman blue iguana is found nowhere else in the world except for Grand Cayman. So we have a tremendous responsibility from a global perspective to ensure that this animal doesn't go into extinction. This legislation, for the first time, will allow us to put management plans in place for the blue iguana and actually have a legal and a legislative framework to implement the management plan.
The draft National Conservation Law makes conservation on land as important as preservation of the marine environment.
The main benefit that this new piece of conservation legislation will have for us here in Cayman is that for the first time it will allow us to manage marine and terrestrial issues together in terms of a conservation framework. The existing framework that we're working under, the Animals Law and the Marine Conservation Law, separate issues on land and issues in the marine environment. So this legislation will also allow us to set up national parks and reserves and other types of protected areas.
The draft legislation will also ensure that environmental issues are taken into consideration in development projects, give the Department of Environment and its officers greater capacity to enforce the law, and allow for more community participation. The law also enables the Cayman Islands to meet its global treaty obligations.
Cayman is party to a number of international environmental agreements, and we have obligations under those environmental agreements. The legislation as drafted will allow us to meet those obligations. The moment we don't have a framework for meeting many of the obligations that we have.
The National Conservation Law will safeguard Cayman's biodiversity, empower the island's people, and protect its future. Voice your support for the proposed legislation by filling in an online comment form available from www.doe.ky. Printed copies can be picked up from the DOE office or any of the district public meetings that will be held in July. Comments can be submitted by email to doe@gov.ky or faxed to 949-4020 or mailed to NCL Comment, care of Department of Environment, PO Box 486, Grand Cayman, KY1 1006. The public consultation period will last a month, closing on Friday, July 16. Copies of the proposed law and a guide to the law can be downloaded from the department's website.